sentence. Well, now there's an amazing opportunity for young and talented people in the rapidly expanding area of jurisprudence. Yes, you can have success, even wealth, by enrolling now in the famous judge's school. You may be under the impression that it takes years of training to become a judge, but you're wrong. America's ever-increasing backlog of court cases and the shortage of qualified judges have created a crying need, and more old judges are leaving the bench every day. Just look at today's headlines. Judge indicted for extortion.
This show contains adult language and situations which may be considered offensive to some viewers and or children, and lots of gambling. Live from the Bailey Grand on the boardwalk in Atlantic City, it's the Greg Sterle Show. Greg's guests tonight include comedian Pat Cooper, Buddy Hackett, and musical guest Keely Smith with Sam Butera on The Witnesses. Yeah, it's a yowza yowza hooah type of show tonight, so get ready. Get Witnesses, not Waitresses, that's Patty Donahue, some other band from the 80s. They did, I know what boys want, I know what guys want.
They want to screw me.
You could be the new waitress there.
Let them.
Uh-oh.
I know what boys like.
Like one of your singers, she could be the new waitress.
Boys like. Boys like.
Me.
Me.
La na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Boys like.
Me.
Boys like.
Here we are, hey, we're on the air.
Boys like me, la 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 la.
Now, you know, I don't really hate South Buffalo bad around. You think I hate South Buffalo, but I don't. I love South Buffalo, man. They got the beer there. They got the houses there. They got the cars. They got it all. I love South Buffalo.
Former mayor.
Don't tell me I don't love South Buffalo, man.
Okay. Where'd
you get that idea anyways? What did I ever say about South Buffalo?
Oh, a lot of things.
Like what? Name one. Can you name one, Ron?
Yeah,
name one, you bastard!
You said something about the KKK, goddamn you.
The KKK, well, they got an off-branch office there, don't they, Tim?
Sure, why not? Hey, there's a phone off the hook.
Oh,
oh.
It's my mother.
Renee, she hung up on
Renee
us.
Hung
she'll
up
call back.
Oh,
cut
mother.
Her up. Hang her up. Hang her up. Hang her up.
What's wrong with your hair, man? Do you ever think about going to, like, a hairdresser?
All the time.
You're looking like crap.
I go to the same one you go to.
Punch you in the face.
It's Friday.
What if I punch you in the face?
And
right
that's
going
to help my hair do, right?
Well, it couldn't hurt.
You're right. I'll fix it after.
So, Ronald, what do you call 100 lesbians with guns?
South Buffalo.
Militia Etheridge. Jeez. I heard that one in Atlantic City. That's a good one.
Oh, now the thing with you, Bad, is that you talk constantly in real life. And now we are on tape.
Never says anything.
Live
never
on
says
camera.
A word.
You never say a word. You never say anything. Are you camera shy?
Lights
is that
out.
What it is?
Yeah. Nobody's home.
Lights out tonight. Trouble in the Heartland.
Trouble with the phones.
A head-on collision.
It's like my thing.
Where is Jill when
smashing
we need her?
It, smashing in my gut.
Where
man?
Is
it's,
Jill?
It's my thing.
What's your thing? Not talking? Oh, okay. Let's just clip then.
No, let's just stand here and.
We're back with Harpo Marx, part of the Marx Brothers.
Rapunzel Glockenspiel.
Yeah.
That's a great wig you got there, Harpo.
It's
you
not a wig, it's my hair.
Oh, you're not doing another accent, are you? Oh, you hate when he does those accents.
I don't know about those accents, Rapunzel. Rapunzel, I don't know.
Let's be obvious about it.
Hey!
Let's be obvious about it. Those accents suck. I hate those accents.
Greg's a brutal critic, Rapunzel.
No offense or anything, but...
Wait a second here!
Ooh, she's getting excited.
This is the time of the show when Tim...
I think the microphone... Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
You can hear me.
So what's the point here? Tim's going to cut your hair? Is that supposed to be funny or something?
No, it's not going to be funny. Not the way he's doing it. You have to do it properly.
With these Rapunzel, come on.
Do it.
Come on, all right.
Both of you stand up. I'll do the play-by-play.
No,
sit down.
You're supposed to...
All right, get behind.
Have a seat.
Tim Sawacki.
All right. The hair.
At the 18th hole.
Right.
You know how women are about their hair.
Well,
I'm going to let you cut mine. Woo! Woo! I don't know how to get
I did absolutely feet. Nothing there.
Yeah, that was
okay.
Great.
Okay.
I'm really impressed.
Okay, go.
I'll just cut what you talk.
Yeah, okay.
Aren't you going to ask me any questions?
Can I ask you any
I
questions?
I need a question.
Oh, man, there's a lot of noise in my headphones.
What's wrong with one of your headphones?
With my headphones? Well, they're falling. Hello, can you hear me?
All right, why don't you just take your headphones off, Guinevere, because we don't need you to talk anyways. Yeah, take them off, put them down.
Thank you.
But I want to talk.
Renee, we have to get, see if we can go to Renee on hold. Is that possible? Or
yeah. Renee. I can't hear
you. Oh, man, this is really bad technically.
Hello?
Renee, hi.
Yes.
Hi, Renee.
Hi.
Hi, it's Greg Sterling from the Greg Sterling Show calling.
Yes, Greg.
Renee, Tim is cutting my hair.
He is.
Yes.
Can you talk about your experience going to Philadelphia and vomiting on my co-host, Tim Serecki?
Yeah, I've been told it was a wonderful experience.
Yeah, Renee, I loved it. I got sick because of it. Thank you.
Others have told me that also that I've observed.
So I think he's blaming you vomiting on him for getting a cold. Is that the way it works? Is that the way it works, Renee?
My vomiting on him getting
yeah.
cold?
Right.
That might have some connection,
so you,
yes.
Okay, so you're calling up, or we're calling you, or you're calling us, or we're calling you to talk about some movie? Is that what we're doing?
Yeah.
What film did you want to talk about this week?
Well, I was going to diss a film, you know.
Yeah, because you've been sick all week?
Ms. Negative.
Right.
But I've decided to recommend.
Mm-hmm.
But not a film.
Not a film, a book.
No, I've decided to recommend.
A play.
To film fans, you know, film appreciators.
Film buffs?
Film buffs.
Yeah. But some Japanese thing?
Buffalo News.
Mm-hmm.
That they, if they should, you know, use the reviews to decide whether or not to see a film.
Right.
That they should do the exact
opposite. You're talking about Jeff Simon.
The exact opposite of whatever film.
You're talking about Jeff Simon.
Recommends or does not recommend.
So you're saying that Jeff Simon has really terrible taste and everything he says is wrong?
No, I'm saying that Jeff Simon writes about Jeff Simon.
Would you say that Jeff Simon is the greatest American writer of the 20th century?
I believe that, you know, Jeff Simon, not too many
Merry
people,
Christmas.
You know, Jeff Simon doesn't seem to understand that not a whole lot of people are interested in a middle-aged...
Renee, the news loves us, so keep it down.
Yeah. Good point, Tim.
What's on?
Tim, it's great when Tim chimes in with these really poignant comments.
What's on?
He said that the Buffalo News loves us. We were on the cover of Gusto, so please don't call off this show and put down Jeff Simon, who you know is a personal hero of mine.
Oh, yes, well, I mean...
You know that I love Jeff, right?
Anthony Violani, you can put him down, but not Jeff.
I'm sorry.
Exactly.
Well, see,
okay.
Like, when I read the review, I want to know about the movie, not about Jeff Simon.
Well, I hate to tell you, I think Jeff just, he goes off on tangents.
No,
but
he goes off on Jeff Simon.
But no, they're meaningful tangents.
His
He's a caring
daughter.
Individual who's trying to tell you about movies.
His teenage daughter. Tall, leggy blondes with
yeah.
deep breasts.
Well, there's nothing wrong with that.
No, which is...
I mean, you go to see the movies just because they're young men who you like
right,
to see, right?
Funny,
so what's the difference
it?
If I go see a movie with a leggy blonde with big breasts? I mean, what's the big deal?
With young, good-looking men in them?
No.
I find that very ironic, but he...
So you're saying he's jealous?
Well, I
have you taken any Vicks NyQuil this week, Renee?
I've been taking a lot of drugs.
What are you doing? Get your finger out of my eye, you stupid bitch. Jesus.
Hey, wait.
God.
No, allowed. Have some NyQuil.
Oh, yeah. Have some NyQuil. This will cheer me up.
No, but apart from that...
It'll knock you for a loop.
Oh, man.
Coca-Colas.
It'll rock me.
The drug of choice.
Sorry, what did you say, Renee?
I couldn't
hear you. I'm drinking NyQuil.
What about the Gusto Real Rock and Roll article?
Did you read that?
What?
Going down?
Roger Daltrey.
Renee, I can only talk about movies with you, sorry.
Yeah, it's rock and roll movies.
Oh, rock and roll movies.
It's
no, I didn't
on the cover
catch
of
that.
Gusto.
No, I didn't catch that, sorry.
Oh, okay.
I saw that.
I saw it. It was very poorly written.
I thought so, too.
By those critics from the Dallas
Renee,
Morning News. Great
yes.
paper.
I have to say goodbye to you forever.
Forever?
Forever?
Yes, it's
no,
over.
Not forever.
On this day in history in 1888,
okay, well,
Tarzan
that's
was born.
Fine. I hope.
Which Tarzan? Johnny Weissmuller?
Clip. I gotta go, Renee. Thank
bye,
you. Ray. Thanks a lot, though.
No problem.
Have a good night.
Okay.
Bye.
Okay.
Bye, Renee.
Bye.
Up on me
bye,
again.
Bye, everyone.
Bye. Clip.
Greg All right, we're back with Karen Grimes, superstar.
Greg Sterling.
No superstar in comparison to you, Greg.
Yes, you are. Everywhere you go, people stop and stare, and they say, who is that lovely woman with the yellow hair?
With the yellow hair.
It's like the very happy color.
But I was never a... No, it's Greg Sterlacci show.
This is Greg Sterlacci.
But you're not really blonde, though, are you?
Huh?
You're not really blonde, though, are you?
I was born a blonde.
You were born a blonde?
I was born a blonde.
Dirty blonde, right?
Nope, blonde is that.
Action.
And then what happened?
Starlights.
Did you go downhill or something? Is that what happened?
It was a time thing.
Action sack.
It's definitely a time thing.
Now, the first time I met you, you were going out with Yad Cruzy, superstar.
Oh.
Another superstar. Two superstars.
What?
When two superstars meet, it's a humbling experience.
Superstar.
Right, Tim?
Where did this come from, Greg? I never heard anything about Yad being a superstar.
Guitar. Yeah.
You mean
guitar,
Paul?
Guitar, Yad.
Guitar legend.
Paul Rosevich.
Yes. Greg.
Karen, I'm doing something. Yeah, what do you want to say? What?
I was just going to say it was a very intense relationship that lasted all of maybe 2.5 weeks.
Yeah, it was pretty bad, wasn't it? He was a horrible person, wasn't he? You can admit it right here on the air.
That's right. He lives in the suburbs, Mo. He doesn't
Starlight
watch this show.
I thought he lived in New York City.
Starlight Show.
No,
he got married and moved to New York City.
Yeah.
Did you miss that part of his life?
Oh, God.
So anyways, the first time we
today
met...
Today is Rodney Dangerfield's birthday. He's 75 years old.
Hey, what do you know?
Who?
Rodney.
Oh, I get no respect.
Hey.
No, the first time we met, you were heckling me from the audience. I was playing in a parking lot.
Yeah,
with my
the
band,
Village Green. Village Green parking lot.
With my band, The Rockers.
No,
remember that band, Tim? The
I
Rockers?
Loved them.
Chemical
yeah.
Number 5. No, oh, it was Chemical Number 5.
Heather Halloween.
Heather Halloween was there, yeah.
I was throwing things at you. I remember that.
Yeah, why were you being such a bitch to me when you didn't even know me?
I could tell right away. I knew right away.
You knew what an obnoxious prick I was just by seeing me there?
And yeah, oh yeah.
Like
oh yeah,
the body
oh yeah.
Standards.
It's kind of scary. I was written all over your aura.
And then you went out to a big waitressing career.
Being taken over.
Yes. I
waiting on drunks at bars.
Yeah.
No offense.
Hey, did you hear
no
Greg?
Offense.
Did you hear Greg's
I waited
career?
On you a billion times.
Did you hear
times,
his new
Greg.
Career though, Greg?
Craig,
me,
I waited
me if
a
I'm wrong,
billion
Greg.
Times.
Greg.
Remember?
Yeah.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Maybe I might have been looped on NyQuil.
Right, I think
night,
you were
you
drunk.
Me,
I think you were drunk when I talked to you.
You called me and you said.
Right. Go on.
I just got assigned by the Edge. I'm going to be a DJ on the Edge. I'm going to be a DJ. Rich Wall's going to train me now, Greg.
Richard Wall to you.
That means no more Who, no right. More Elvis Costello.
Oh, I love those people, though. They're
play,
so
you
good.
You have to play, like, Tragically Hip.
What are you trying to do? Scream at me and Guinevere? Jesus Christ, oh, my God.
You have to play Smashing Pumpkins with that Fester guy? Oh, no.
Listen, oh. Tim, as you well know.
The Edge. No, Greg, you can't
Tim,
sell out. Greg,
you
can't.
As you well know, I love...
You can't sell out.
I love the alternative rock that the kids are putting out nowadays. I do. I
that
love
Fester
it.
Guy from that Pumpkins band. What's the story?
He's Fester. See. Greg, really.
Karen, please say something. Don't just keep saying C Ryder. Say something. Jesus Christ.
From
oh, my
Spanish.
God.
Ah.
Oh,
well, right. If you shut up once, I could, like, get a word in edgewise.
Can you do a little monologue for us? Go. I'll just relax here while you do the monologue. Get my,
okay,
hair. Get my hair together.
Okay, Cousin It.
I do look like Cousin It in the Addams
Family. You do look like Cousin You've always looked like Cousin It.
All right. Anyways, that's... Guinevere, I'm trying to do a show here. Do you understand that? Do you have a concept I'm doing a show here? Do you understand? Anyway, go, Karen, what do you stop talking for? Monologue.
Keep going, David.
Oh,
keep going.
All right.
Go. I'm going to relax and get my hair together.
What I was going to tell you is Greg has this really this big thing about being a rock and roll star.
Oh,
he really, when I worked for Glenn Medeiros, he kept calling me every single
Glenn
day.
Glenn Medeiros, really?
Yeah, he kept calling me every single day to
that
ask
guy
me
is
if
hot.
Yeah, to ask me if Glenn would listen to his songs.
I never did that. What are you talking
about?
Yeah,
he did.
I never did
Greg, was
that.
It like
you
banging your head against a wall when you listened to Glenn Medeiros?
14 years of banging my head against
listening
the wall.
To Glenn Medeiros, 14 long
14
years.
14 years, yeah. He wanted to do a duet with him.
What's your perfect man like?
Like
me?
You, Greg.
Yeah, what's your perfect man like, too?
Oh, Rock. There he is, right there.
On this
Rock,
day
get up here, man. Let's see you.
National Hockey
Let's see
League
the per- Come here. Come on, baby.
It was for him?
Get in here.
Yes.
Really?
The perfect man. Here he is. Let's get a shot of the perfect man. Look at this guy. He's got style. He's got class. He's got a big hot ass. He's got it all.
Thank you,
look at him. Look at this
no
man.
Idea
look
doing,
at the sex appeal.
Oh. Yeah, more.
So is that your idea of
swallowed.
A perfect man?
No, you are, Greg.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What is it about me that you like so much? My great looks, my pug nose.
It's your it's
my big fat stomach.
Pugsley.
It's your physique.
My physique?
Yeah.
My legs, like my legs.
Oh yeah. Yeah, let's try show everybody.
Jamie Lee Curtis.
I
want to
see it.
38 today.
I'm a little
38.
I'm a little
she's
shy.
She's got great legs.
Yeah.
Now you're Guinevere, Jesus.
So,
anyways,
so Greg, why did you ask me on the show?
Because you're so beautiful, and you're so personable. You're so intelligent. Don't you think so, Tim?
Oh, yeah, sure. Why not? Hey, yeah, sure. You are. I agree. I don't
Robert,
I don't dismiss her lightly like I do with most of our guests. Like that.
Or Rapunzel from the land of Latvia.
Rapunzel Glockenspiel.
Now, let's get to the real issue here. You're going out with that jerk, that prick. That scum of the earth.
He hates Tony. I have no idea
Anthony
why.
Anthony Bellani.
I have
Tony
no
Bellani.
No, I don't
why
know.
Would
Tony
you,
who?
Why?
Tony who?
Bellani. Now, why would you waste...
Wait a second. Is he that dark-haired guy?
Me and Greg wrote the song
about
him.
The big buddy Holly Glasses?
Oh, man, he's been stalking
like
me.
Stalking you.
He's
Tony,
stalking
no
me.
Phony, baloney, it's Tony.
He has definitely been
the
stalking
tiger.
Me.
Tiger.
Hey.
He has definitely been stalking me. You didn't
so
know
So wherever
that?
You go?
He, everywhere I go, Art Voice, like Nancy, Nancy Parisi will be there with her camera.
Right.
He jumps in. He
Whoa.
Jumps in the pictures just to try and make us look like we're some sort of couple or something.
So you think like this guy's maybe...
At last, I am warm.
You think maybe he's desperate and dateless, huh? Is that what it is?
Well,
is
you never
he,
know.
You think he's a serial killer?
I've thought about
no,
it.
No, seriously, though, Karen.
I don't understand
how a person like you can waste your time with a person like Tony Bellani, superstar from Bird on Offbeat Cinema.
I told you the man
no,
is stalking
me. Seriously, Karen, just answer me for real. Don't give me this crap-ass story, this funny little story about stalking.
Because he's from Kenmore.
No, really.
Home of the Blues.
What do you see in him? Is it his car?
Home of the Blues.
I mean, it can't be his personality. He has none, right? I mean, he just has that, like,
he's stalking
that grady...
He's
come on, Karen,
me.
Just
be
honest. The
inventor of the Ferris
the show,
wheel
the show
died
is all about honesty.
Well, you know, I've been in a lot of fear, you know, over this whole thing.
You've had a lot of affairs?
No, I've been in a lot of fear over this.
You've been in a lot of fear over what?
You know, about this guy with dark hair. I mean, now I found out his name is Tony Bellani. I guess maybe
Greg,
I can
I
go and, like, file
like
charges or something.
Playing tragically hip and fester music, man.
Oh, what do you want me to do? Play the blues like you?
Red Hot Chili Hot Peppers.
What are you going to do?
Play those songs.
Gonna
play those songs
gonna DJ
like
for
you?
The Edge.
Are you serious?
But that's what he told me last night. Either that or I was looped on NyQuil. I don't
I think
know.
Looped on NyQuil.
I think he's selling out. Kinda
I think
like,
he is, too.
Kind of like...
How is that selling out?
You sold out.
Well, he got tired of banging his head against the wall for 14 years.
What do you think I do for a living?
You work at a law firm.
No. Nope.
You're an accountant.
Nope.
Martial arts expert.
Nope.
you're one of those women who go out escort service.
No. I wear these
the song
things.
About my favorite
oh, yeah,
nuclear
that's
right. submarine.
That's right. Yeah,
so
you do phone calls.
New Orleans is sinking.
Yeah.
What do you
do?
Like a catalog?
Phone sex.
You do phone sex?
I do phone sex.
Let's hear it.
Really?
Let's hear an orgasm
yeah,
voice right now. Come on. Moan and wail and lick your palms. Work up a puddle. That's it. Work up a puddle. Come on.
Keep going.
Come on.
That was
on.
Greg there. No. Greg, he lost my concentration.
Oh, okay. I'm going to look the other way. Ready? Here, start again. Here we go.
Go ahead.
One, two, three, four, five, six. All right. Keep going, baby. All right.
He's really into this.
I'm really into it. Right?
Well,
no, this is Tim's thing. Anyway,
it was for a short spell.
Yeah.
It was for a spell.
So actually,
really, how many thousands did you spend on it?
Yeah. And did your girlfriend wonder about those
no,
big bills?
Over the show. On the show.
Over the show. Over the show.
On the air.
Oh,
yeah, right.
Trying to regroup
now.
On the show.
He's trying to regroup.
A little clarification in order,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
A little clarification.
I can just go and see him going to Chase Manhattan going, excuse me, miss.
Hey, we weren't even talking to you.
Greg. Greg, think about it. Chase Manhattan, going to Chase Manhattan, so, asking for a few thousand.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, for the 900 numbers.
So,
yeah.
Tim, you've actually been like, making all these sex phone calls? I mean, phone calls.
Sure, why
phone
not?
Phone sex calls?
1-800-WET-HOLE. That's my favorite one.
So what's your dream girl's name?
Ebony, right?
Tiffany.
Does your beautiful
Tiffany or Amber.
Does your beautiful girlfriend mind that you're making these calls, Tim?
No, not at all.
Mae West haven't died on this day.
1978. 78.
1980.
Karen, so what do you actually do? You actually like a catalog? You like A&A's catalog or something? Where you say,
no, computers.
Computers. Why do you have to wear the headphones then?
Over the phone. Because I'm...
Oh, you help people with their computers over the phone?
No, I sell computers over the phone.
Oh, I didn't think you were...
But I place the orders in.
Oh, you place the orders. So you just... All you do is sell computers over the phone. That's all you do.
Yeah, but I know how to network them.
What does that mean?
I know how to hook them up so they talk to each other.
Did you ever go to network?
Question of the week.
Yeah, I've been in
Should
network.
Greg
in fact,
sell
I've
out
been in the VIP.
Going to the wedge.
I have been in the
Should
VIP
join the wedge?
Area of network.
Question of
I
the
remember
week.
When that first a note.
Well, I'm sorry. I wasn't listening that whole time.
Remember
what
the VIP area of network?
Yeah, Tim used to work there.
Sure.
He used to hang out with Cornelius Bennett, the Biscuit.
I got O.J. Simpson.
Yeah, he met O.J. Simpson in February.
Hand.
This club doesn't
shook
fit
his hand. Yeah.
Oh, speaking of, when do you put the ski mask
fit.
On, Greg?
I'm getting
That's,
a little sick of this.
Saturday
I'm getting a little sick of this goddamn stupid ski mask joke.
I really want to see the ski mask.
I mean, I've heard it a million times now. I'm really sick of it. It's just ridiculous.
But I really, really
where
want to see
it. Greg?
Where is it, man?
Bring the ski mask out, Greg.
I'm not ski mask. I'm Greg Sterlitz. Why would
Greg,
I name the show the Greg Sterlitz show if I was ski mask? I'd name it the ski mask show, wouldn't I? I mean, what do you... People with
on this day
these
in
dumb
1968,
jokes, they just,
the Beatles
these
released
dumb
the White
jokes,
Album.
They just... People just say over and over and over.
What a masterpiece it was.
That was the best album of the 60s. Did you like that album? Did you like Revolution Number 9? Number
what year
nine?
Was that? 19? You're a lot older than me, Greg.
Yeah, I'm 31. How old are you, 23?
Yeah, you're allowed to learn me.
You're like 23, right?
Yeah.
And Tony Bellani, your boyfriend's like 46.
He's old enough to be 46. He's old enough to be
That's
your father.
You're like, oh my God.
No.
Get off on those older men, huh, Karen?
Give me back my son!
Yeah, so that would have made me... Wait, Greg. When I met you, how old were you?
17. How old was I?
Yeah.
I was 24, 25.
And I was 17 and I was waitressing in bars?
Yeah, I said you're 23 now.
Oh, okay, yeah.
I didn't say you were waitressing then. I said later on, you went on to a great waitressing career.
Honey, I was waitressing then.
Well, so you're like 20... So what, wait, oh, you can't waitress in a bar if you're under 18 or under 21? Come on, you know you can. When was the first time you went to a bar? Like when you were 13 or something, right?
I was
right?
18.
You're a chick, right? So they always let the beautiful chicks in early. It doesn't matter how young they are. They let them in, right, Tim?
Yeah.
Because they want all the guys there to go, hey, there's some beautiful young chicks here.
Let's get drunk and pick them up.
Drunk and rape them. You know what? That's what they're thinking. I mean, let's just get
them. No.
Greg really had a pretty reality problem with that.
He did?
When he walked into bars, you should have seen
a pretty reality problem. What the hell does that mean?
Pretty bad reality problem.
What does that mean? Pretty bad reality problem.
Reality points.
What are you talking about?
You know, I was expecting this more like you know, Greg's world. Like, party on, dude, right? Yeah. Excellent, yeah.
No, that's fine.
This whole show, yeah.
Oh, you like Tim
Pardon my French.
Tim would be like Garth or Dana
Garvey. I took lessons,
Garvey.
You know.
Huh?
I took French lessons.
You did?
I thought you took burping lessons.
No, it's just my imitation.
Can you burp on cue, Tim?
Bonjour.
Can you burp on cue?
No, of course not. Don't be silly.
Bullshit, you can't do.
You look very nice in drag.
This is not drag. Consider this drag?
I've seen him in drag.
You ever seen me in that ski mask?
No.
Ski mask. I will come to your house and kill you. Ski mask.
Hold on, I gotta look at the monitor.
Oh, the bad thing. Ski mask.
Ski mask.
What do you think of Ski Mask show? You ever seen it?
No, I haven't.
You never saw it?
Mm-hmm.
You ever seen any of the Kate Webster show? You ever see the Rhythm and Blues Review or the Home of the Future show or the Dance Marathon with Dick Clark?
Hey, on Comics TV, Greg.
Comics!
I don't get
Clark Fulkerson was on it today.
Really?
I get Adelphia.
June Buggy was showing it out
really?
For the mask.
What are you doing on Comics TV, though? They're a rock band.
When was I on Comics
I'm talking
TV?
To him.
Shaggy. he had him on at the closing end of the show.
No, I've been on Aussie.
Closing end of the show, special musical guest, Doom Buggy.
Wow, that makes no sense. They're not a cartoon.
I know, it doesn't make
well,
sense.
Well, they kind of are. Clark
yeah, Fulkerson. They are.
Clark Fulkerson. Yoinks.
No, Karen.
Yoinks. What's it like being on Offbeat Cinema? Do you hope someday to replace Connie Selica, who plays Zelda? You'll help to be the next chick on the show? They've had three chicks now. You could be the number four chick.
No, I'm quite content.
Plus, you'll be with your boyfriend, Birdie. And Airborne Eddie, as we know him, Airborne Ale. Tell me your opinion of that show, your honest opinion, even though you're on it a lot. What do you feel about it? Do you think it's a great show? Good scripts, good dialogue, nice black and white cinematography.
I kind of like the fact that I get to sit in the background and do nothing.
Did they give you a check for that?
No.
Oh, damn.
But I get to be on color on your show.
Now, so what's it like working on that show? You don't really do anything. So there's no real work. You live with your parents still? Tim, are you still here with us,
Greg? I can't imagine you playing Poe. I can't imagine you playing any Poe. Johnny.
I have to, man. It's my job.
I can't imagine you doing that, Greg.
What?
Selling out like that, man.
Let me do it for you right now.
You're not going to be able to play who or Elvis Costello, your two favorites.
You can play Elvis Costello.
This is 103.3 The Edge. That was Smashing Pumpkins with their new hit. Fester, Denver, Columbus, Ohio.
I feel like I'm shedding.
Yeah, you are. So you still live with your parents, Karen, after all these years, even though you're 23? Come on, get out of the house. What are you doing? Come on. I'm really depressed about it.
I'm saving my money to buy a house. I'll probably buy a house.
You're going to buy a house?
Yeah.
And then when are you getting married to Tony Bologna? Bologna. I didn't mean to say Bologna. I know it's a ridiculous non-joke, but when are you getting married? When are you getting married? Come on, stand
when
up.
When am I getting
please,
married?
Please stand up, please. I'm begging you to stand up. I'm begging you to stand up.
Are you proposing to me, Greg?
Yes, I've been secretly in love with you for 6.5 years.
Johnny.
Now, what's...
Maybe I'll have to say no to Tony, then.
All right, please marry me. Will you please marry me? I want to be with you.
Greg, which three of these edge bands do you prefer? Elastica, Republica, or Psychotica?
I'm proposing. Do you understand
Republica,
that?
Republica, Elastica, or Psychotica?
I'm proposing, you idiot!
Republica, Elastica, or Psychotica? Which one do you prefer?
You're not the co-host. You're the sidekick.
Which
sidekick
do you prefer?
Sidekick!
Oh, okay.
Anyways. Now, Karen, please, I want to be with you forever. I want to live with you forever. I want to live in that new house you're going to buy, for one thing.
With the pool in the back?
What about the Muck Divers?
No, it's not a band.
like, you gonna play any garbage? I mean, I don't mean like.
What about the Muff Divers?
The Muff.
You like them? You like, know what I'm talking about?
The oh yeah. Okay. Muff sure.
Divers?
Yeah.
Tim, I don't want to talk about this anymore. Is it any of your business?
You made it my business.
He really has to start reaching when he starts reaching for those lesbian jokes, doesn't he?
I didn't do a lesbian joke. I didn't do a lesbian joke.
Oh, you didn't?
You think muff diving is a lesbian joke?
Or is it a guy joke?
It can be either or. It has nothing to do with lesbians. I mean, do you know anything about sex at all, Karen? Why don't you take a course?
I'm pretty
Why don't you watch that Woody Allen movie?
I'm
really?
Pretty inexperienced, yeah.
Oh, inexperienced. Okay. Yeah. I thought you said experience.
No, I'm pretty inexperienced.
Oh, yeah, sure.
No, I'm pretty innocent. That's why I still live at home with my parents.
What are they like? Are they like an old married couple?
Mm-hmm.
Do they have...
They have rocking chairs and everything.
Johnny.
Do you want to have a baby? Is that like a foremost goal in your life, to have a child and raise it to adulthood and then kill it?
No, I was thinking about turning it and sticking it on you.
what?
Raising it to, you know,
like Mike
stick
Myers?
On you.
Like Mike Myers?
Kind of like that, yeah.
You ever see that movie, Halloween?
Put your face up on
Tim,
one of those little
Tim,
murals hanging
me,
over
Tim,
the crib.
You're creeping me out, man.
I'm Greg Sterlace. We're on Live on the Air. This is 103.3 The Edge. Next guest, Billy Coogan. He is Coogat. Listen to this new smash track by him.
1979. Take it away, Billy.
All right, here we go.
What's that?
Ow! That's the monkey. Now, we only have a few seconds left here, Karen, in this raucous, rambling, maniac kind of show.
Are you going to hit me with that or something?
Yes, I am.
The Edge, Greg. Why?
Greg,
why the Edge?
See how hard this thing is?
Can you
get away
see
from
that?
Me.
At the end of every show, Karen, we take this and we throw it at the guest's head.
No, we'll throw it at
and
him.
And if I hit the guest's head, I win a prize. If I don't, well, what the hell? I'll try again, right? The second time. Okay, you ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
Are you going to put your arms up?
Yeah. Why you dare?
What do you mean? It's only a monkey, Karen. It's only a monkey. Don't be afraid. Sit down.
Why don't I do it to you?
Sit down. Oh,
I've had
it done before.
Then okay. I'll win a prize.
Johnny.
Now, Richard, are we at the right time, or are we going to go farther this tonight?
We're going to take this show right over the edge, Greg.
This is real professional,
Greg. Hey, stop it. Hey.
We can go all the way up to 30-25.
We're taking it right to the edge.
Truly professional,
we'll put
Greg.
Put the music in about at 29, all right?
Greg, it's truly professional of you.
To throw the monkey at your head?
this whole show.
I'm Mr. Professional. Hi, fans. I'm Mr. Professional.
I love
you. Here we go.
No.
You ready?
There you are.
What a wimp. This damn thing. Anyways, Friday nights, Karen, at 7 p.m. You know what's on? You know what's on Friday nights at 7 p.m.? You know
Inside Edition. Everyone knows that.
No,
Friday nights at what, 7?
Inside Edition.
No.
Home of the Future show.
Oh, that's right.
Okay.
I need to, you have to define your terms.
Dance? No, I'm going to hang on to the monkey.
You got to define your terms.
Are you going to dance? Okay, we need the music now.
Play the song. Elvis Costello or The Who?
Not you Elvis.
This is it?
We're supposed to dance?
Be careful out there.
The Who.
There. Keep it going,
Richard. No.
Get out of here.
That's a man from the
Mike, don't try to cut in, Tony.
Oh, did you recognize it? Oh, good.
Here we go. Here's the music. Here we go.
Well, if I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out a warning, I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land. Well, if I had a bell, I'd ring it in the morning, I'd ring it in the evening, all over this land. I'd ring out danger, I'd ring out a warning, I'd ring out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land. Well, if I had a song, I'd sing it in the morning.